It's Monday the 2nd of April. We're all particularly excited because this afternoon we're going to be joined by none other than Guy Sebastian. Live in the studio, I think we might even be able to persuade him to have a little sing for us.
Oh, and he has got the most beautiful voice. I love Guy Sebastian.
Fabulous voice. Mm. And in fact, once upon a time, to become a rock and roll star in this country, you drank bourbon, shagged chicks and played gigs on the sweaty pub circuit. But one of Australia's biggest stars has done it the newfangled way. He won Australian Idol in 2003. He sold over 1 million albums and is still going strong since then. It's a treat. He's here. Guy the Fro. But where is it?
The
Sebastian!
Expo, it's all gone now.
It's gone.
All gone, yes.
Your calling card.
Exactly. It had to go. I can't wear hats without, you know, having to sticky tape it down and all that, so... Yeah,
and it was easier. Summer, it's like being a sheep. You've got to shear your head so you know...
Exactly. And, cool. You know, it needed a change.
Well, it's interesting, though. I mean, even though you've done it the newfangled way, you still have to change your image a lot, though, as a pop star, don't you?
I guess so. I guess you've got to evolve with the times.
Your inner Kylie?
Yeah, exactly. You know, you've got to keep...
Like, this new album is a different style. Your previous albums have been more urban and R&B, and this one's kind of gone a bit more funk, a bit more rock. Was that a conscious decision?
I don't know if it was conscious because I went away and wrote for ages, and I went overseas, did the whole trip, and I was writing the same old sort of stuff, and it really bored me to tears.
What's
to be
the
honest.
Same old sort of stuff?
Just like what I'd done on my previous couple of albums.
Lyrics-wise or music-wise?
Lyrics and also music-wise, stylistically. And the music industry, like what you hear on radio changes so quickly. Mm. And then I sort of packed it in for a while and just thought I'd have a bit of a break.
Did you have a writer's block?
Bit of a writer's block, yeah, which happens all the time.
And, do you ever go to those camps? Like, they have writer's camps and there's, like, you know, Natalie and Brulia.
I have, actually, yeah.
Have you?
Yeah, there was one around the corner from my house at Palm Beach, which was fun. And
Were there any megastars there?
No, there was Katie Noonan was there.
From George?
Yeah, who, in my opinion, Katie's amazing. The best singer in the country, yeah.
Guy, who inspires you musically? Who do you look to for inspiration?
There's so many different people. I love the Beatles. I love, you know, the old school Stevie stuff. Donny Hathaway is awesome. And just lately, just trying to broaden my my listening, you know, like listening to old funk stuff like the Brothers Johnson and all that sort of stuff.
Is there any kind of hierarchy between people that have done it your way through a reality TV series and people that slog it out like Laura Imbruglia on the pub circuit and stuff like that? Like, do you notice within the industry that there's any division between the reality TV successes and the ones that have done it the old-fashioned way?
Of course, there's always going to be that. Idol for me wasn't a matter of I'd never sung before and I just one day saw this TV show on, you know, and I thought, oh, I might try out for that. I can't sing or anything and I've never done it before, but I'll go on it. Like, I'd been doing it for years. Like, I'd been working and you know, funnily enough, a lot of my stuff I was doing for free because I was doing a lot of youth work and that sort of stuff
and
a lot of church
work.
Stuff. Yeah. And
in
so,
Adelaide, where he's been for the weekend.
That's right.
Tossing the coin.
For the Crows who lost.
For the Crows!
Yeah,
like Crows, because I'm a Port Power.
Oh, wow. Won.
Hey, we won and it was a really good game. It was the Dockside Cup. Because Port Adelaide and the Fremantle Dockers are their dock teams, you know, like the...
It's called a derby.
Stevedores,
I'm looking at the screen and our reds are clashing so bad.
Yeah,
so bad.
But, Guy, your audience is very broad. I saw you on the Channel 9 Kids Show the other day and they were right into your music. So who? Is it right across the board up to older people as well?
I guess like we were saying about the TV show thing, you know, I enter the industry in a very different way and I think at the end of the day... I guess musical talent will always shine through. You know, we see Shannon who had an awesome album, great songs, and that's all that matters at the end of the day. Because as you know, TV's so fickle; people forget. You know, after you know the Australian Idol comes, and
do you still see Shannon?
Yeah, I still see him, and our lives are so like busy and stuff. But yeah, we catch up every now. And then. I totally didn't answer your question, did I?
No.
Kids. Yeah.
Well, I'm a fan, and I'm much older.
Yeah, at my shows, it's pretty. I'm pretty lucky because of the TV show. I think it opened up my music to a whole, you know,
really
demographic,
wide,
which
yes.
is wide. Yeah.
Fantastic.
So it was Yeah, it was good.
And it's good that you've kept going. I mean, because it would be possible to become an overnight star and be a one-hit wonder, boom, and go. Yeah. But you've
sustained. Not catch the public's imagination or have such terrible things go on in your own life. Poor Casey Donovan hasn't really survived the idol thing.
Yeah, I guess Casey was just, a classic example of just not quite ready for it, you know. She was young and maybe had to sort out some personal stuff. And I mean, musically, she's great and, she's. I'm sure she will hear more from her once she's matured. But
you haven't been conventional either in terms of pop stardom, because you're still heavily involved with your church work. Mm. And in terms of being, you know, one of those Rolling Stones dirty men who go out and shag everything that moves, that's not your style either.
No, it's not. I guess you're talking about Carl, my guitarist.
it's a joke. Is that a weird thing to maintain, given the lustfulness of our industry?
Look, we're all faced with different things every day. We're all faced with challenges, and I guess there's enough of that option. You know, like, I'm not saying that I'm better or I'm worse. Like, I'm just saying that this, what I do is another, it's another lifestyle, you know, and there's enough people who do that sort of stuff, and it takes a bit more guts in my
Wouldn't opinion. Your challenge be at the moment when you're going to propose? Because you've been with Julie for 7 years. Now, she must be hanging out for a ring.
No, you know. She never brings it up.
Doesn't she really, honestly?
Yeah, she's never mentioned the M word.
No, she's such a gorgeous girl. I don't believe you at all.
She just says, however long you want to take, don't worry about it.
You're a lying hound.
So understanding.
Well, I think we should get you behind the mic and have a bit of a sing for us.
No worries.
And we'll look forward to hearing about the wedding one of these days.
Yeah, absolutely.
So, is this song, is it?
Yeah, it's a song I wrote with Carl, who you're about to see his pretty face.
Carl, do you do all the shagging behind scenes?
No.
Carl's got the most beautiful little girl.
Who did you write it about? Anyone in particular?
Well, it's funny you brought up the marriage thing. It's very much a marriage sort of song. It's one of those songs where, and we just wrote it at my house one time, and it sort of takes me back to the Nat King Cole sort of stuff, which I love listening to. And it's the last track on my current album, and so I thought I'd sing it for the ladies.
Off you go.
No worries.
Well, thank you, Guy.
We'll tell everyone about your tour dates. In Sydney on the 4th and 5th of May, in Melbourne on the 18th and 19th of May. As we said, the song that Guy is going to perform is from his new album, Close to the Sun, and it's called Be Mine. Guy Sebastian, everyone.
Lately, I've been having thoughts on my mind. There to tell you, given that solitary time, it's the greatest, most humble thing a heart will ever find. Just promise me that you'll be mine. See, we've been going out quite a while. And baby, the way you move is quite my style. So let me take this chance and put my heart out on the line. I'm just hoping, girl, that you'll be mine. The winds of fate don't often blow away, so let's chase them while we can. Our waves are growing stronger while our hearts are getting younger, and I think we can run a lifetime or two. So take this, baby, take this ring I have here for you and wear it till both our lives are through. See, it's the honest, most perfect gift I can give to you. If you say that you'll agree, girl, if you promise me, I'll give everything I have. If you if you'll be mine.